Good morning to all the students of class 10th A as well as class 10th B. So this is the combined class. The chapter, because we are already doing, so class 10th D knows already. 10th A we are doing chapter Diary of Anne Frank, Annalisa Frank. Her full name is Annalisa Frank, but she became popular with this name only. So that's why I would be using this name only. Diary of I'll be giving you the brief introduction. Actually, this chapter is extracted from one of the famous novels, Diary of Young Girl. Fine. So they have extracted the part of that novel into your syllabus as one of the chapters. So that's why it is named as Diary of Anne Frank. Fine. You all know that what is a diary entry. You have the writing skill also. Whenever we are struggling with our emotions, whenever we need a friend, whenever we want to vent feelings to our emotions, we do make diary entries. Fine. We just write the way we are talking to our friends. We start noting down in a diary. So, but this diary of Anne Frank is a bit different. Why it is different? The background of the chapter is World War II. Fine. So my pace is fine. If you're able to understand me, or I need to slow down, class 10th. Send me thumbs up quickly. Fine. Okay. So the background of the story is World War II. And there was the invasion. You know that invasion when one country invades the other. So you might have read in SST the Nazi invasion. So when Jews community was being thrown out of that country, German, and various concentration camps were set where they were, wherever they will be able to find Jews, the way we are, having Sikh community, Hindu community. So there is one Jew community. So Anne Frank belonged to that Jew community, fine, and obviously her family and other relatives. So whenever Jews were found anywhere, they were being sent to concentration camps. They were brutally handled, brutally, you can say, tackled. And so Otto Frank, father of Anne Frank, I'll be giving you the basic characters, who's there in the family of Anne Frank. Anne Frank is a 13-year-old girl, a teenager girl. Her father, Otto Frank, fine. Her mother, Edith Frank, and she has one elder sister. Fine. Elder sister's name is Margot Frank. Fine. So all they belong to Jews community and they are facing the same trouble. They are being thrown out from their own native place and they were being sent to concentration camps. Now, Otto Frank, father of Anne Frank, decided to go into hiding, a hiding place. So he was having one adjoining building in the office only, to which we call annex. I have written the word annex here. I would be telling you the meaning, fine? So secret annex. So they went to secret annex. Annex is another part of the main building. They decided to go into the hiding because they wanted to save their lives, obviously. So, and they were not aware that because World War II was going on, they wanted to safeguard themselves. Not for days, not for weeks, but they have to go under hiding for long 2 years. Fine? The way, you know, these days people are bound in their homes due to COVID. And how bad we feel that we do not, even though we are going out, we are meeting people, but not to that extent. And we feel so bad and depressed. But these people, as the Frank family and more relatives, they went into hiding in the Otto Frank's office. Clear? Is it clear to everyone? Send me thumbs up quickly. Fine. Then when they went into hiding, this teenager girl, you know, as a teenager, you people are also teenagers. A lot of physical changes, a lot of hormonal changes, a lot of mental changes are going on at that stage. And you need to, you know, be with your friends. You need to talk to someone, to your family, and you want to go out, fine. But at that stage, what happened, Anne Frank, she was not able to go out. Then she, you know, channelized herself into writing. Then now I'm going to explain these points and I would be showing you one video and sharing screen. Let's continue. On her 13th birthday, Anne got a diary from her parents. So when she was in hiding, her 13th birthday falls during those days only. So she got a diary because they were not having any gifts with them. Anne starts writing about daily events, her thoughts, her school grades. Even she would be, you know, they have not mentioned in this chapter, but if you read the novel, you will get to know that she was getting attracted to one of the residents also, one of the boys. So she wrote about that also. So this is how an adolescent struggles in one's life and how she gave vent to her feelings, right? But in this chapter, we would be reading only about her entries made regarding school life, right? She would be discussing about her friends. She would be telling you about her teacher, how her teacher would call her chatterbox of the class, fine? So she started writing diary, her thoughts and school grades. That's why I have just written here, etc. Because there are other things also, but they are not into the chapter of class 10. Then, for 2 long years, this is not comma, okay? This is secret annex. This is post of here. So for 2 long years, the Frank family lives in secret annex. I told you already, because of that invasion, because their life was not safe due to World War II. So they were scared of Nazi invasion. So then they just went into secret hiding. Anne puts her energy in studying and writing. So there are 2 ways of living life. When you are stuck at a place for long 2 years, one thing you can do is crib and cry. These days, you people are not supposed to move much out. You're having online classes. One way is you attend your classes and rest of the time you channelize, you learn a skill online, you imbibe some values. People have started writing blogs. They are more active on social media. But, you know, rather than wasting time, you can, you know, make it fruitful for yourself also. So this is the way she just carried it out. Then she became aloof from other members of Annex. Aloof means alone. So when she started writing, she became more alienated and she used to address her diary as Kitty because she was, talking to diary as if she's talking to a friend. So is it clear to everyone? Whatever I have discussed with class 10th A? Okay, Ashin is the first one to raise that thumb. Very good. Ruhani is saying, okay, fine. So I'm checking whether you're listening or not. This is the way. Now I would be sharing screen with you all. I would be showing one video to you. This one.
This is the first time.
Yes, beta. So this video actually, if you can see, where some students are still joining. So this video is, you know, interview with Otto Frank, and he would be showing the real diary of his daughter Anne Frank. Now you would be asking, where is Anne Frank in this interview? But father is there. She died very young at the age of 16 only. She had a disease. Can you see the subtitles also? You just read it. I'm going to go to the next one. now. Okay, see, he is telling that how it got published actually. This idea was given by one of his friends. Yes. Yes, beta. So you got an idea. I just wanted to show you the diary. Fine. That how she used to write, and she was the only survivor of that. Her father was the only survivor of that concentration camp. Most of the members of that annex died. Fine. And how Anne died, she got an infectious disease called typhus. Fine. And then out of it, she could not survive. Fine. So let's continue the reading. We have read so far. So 10th, you can read it. I have just already explained. We have done this activity also yesterday. The difference between a diary, journal, memoir and all. So we are going to read from page number 50. Yes, 51 actually. We have done this oral comprehension check. So we have read so far when she started writing about, and she made first entry in her diary that she thought that rather than straight away writing, nobody will understand what I'm writing into the diary. So she gave a brief character sketch of her life. You can say brief information about her life, that her father was most adorable father and he got married at the age of 36. Her mother got married when she was 25. So then her sister Margot was born in Frankfurt, Germany. And she was born, Anne Frank was born on 12th June 1929 in Frankfurt. And she lived there till the age of 4. And then parents emigrated to Holland. And mother also went to Holland. But Margot Frank and Anne Frank, both the sisters, they were sent to Aachen to stay with their grandmother. So that's why from here we'll get to know that Annie Frank was so attached with her roots. She was so attached with her grandmother. Fine. After staying with her grandmother, they again went to their parents' home. But she was having a lot of love for her grandmother. Now I would be reading from here. I started right away at the Montessori Nursery School. So this is the part of diary entry only, whatever she has written in her diary. Okay. I started right away at the Montessori Nursery School. I stayed there until I was 6, at which time I started in the first form. In the sixth form, my teacher was Mrs. Cooperus, the headmistress. At the end of the year, we were both in tears as we said a heartbreaking farewell. So she's telling that she started her education in Montessori Nursery School, and till the age of 6, she stayed there. And then it was very difficult for her to leave that school and leaving that kindergarten, you can say. In the summer of 1941, grandma fell ill. Underline this. I told you she was very much attached to her grandmother, but her grandmother fell ill and had to have an operation. So my birthday passed with little celebration. So it was her birthday and her grandma was not well. Grandma died in January 1942. No one knows how often I think of her and still love her. This birthday celebration in 1942 was intended to make up for the other. And grandma's candle was lit along with the rest. So even her grandma died, she was not able to forget her love. And she lit a candle on birthday also for her grandmother. The four of us are still doing well, and that brings me to the present date of 20th June 1942 and the solemn dedication of my diary. Fine, now she is telling that four of us means father, mother, sister and herself. Clear? Why does Anne provide a brief sketch of her life? And what tells you that Anne loved her grandmother? These questions we'll do tomorrow because it's a joint class. Okay. Dearest Kitty, our entire class is quaking in its boots. The reason, of course, is the forthcoming meeting in which the teachers decide who will move up to the next form and who will be kept back. Now, who's the Kitty? She is addressing her diary as Kitty. Fine, beta. Why entire class was shaking with fear? Quaking in its boot means they were quite trembling with fear. And the reason, of course, is the forthcoming meeting in which the teachers decide who will move on to the next form and who will be kept back. Teachers were still deciding that who will be, you know, passing that class, who will be moving to next grade. Half of the class is making bets now. GN and I laugh ourselves silly at the two boys behind us. So she's missing those days when she would go to school along with her friends, CN and Jakes, who have staked their entire holiday savings on their beds. So she and Frank and her friend GN, they are laughing at two boys called CN and Jakes. And they were, you know, making bets that who will go to next class, who will pass, who will not pass and all. From morning to night, it's you are going to pass. No, I'm not. Yes, you are. No, I'm not. The way you people, you know, used to prank each other and during the result days and all. So that kind of excitement and tense they were. Fine. And if you ask me, there are so many dummies that about a quarter of the class should be kept back. But teachers are the most unpredictable creatures on the earth. She's saying that you cannot predict a teacher how she is going to judge us. So let's see who's going to pass the class and who's not. I'm not so worried about my girlfriends and myself. We will make it. So Anne Frank is saying she was not worried about herself and about her friends. The only subject I'm not sure about is math. So she was, you know, maybe she was weak in math. So she was worried about maths only. Otherwise, she was quite confident that she would pass. Anyway, all we can do is wait. Until then, we keep telling each other not to lose heart. I get along pretty well with all my teachers. There are 9 of them, 7 men and 2 women. Mr. Keezing, the old foggy who teaches maths, was annoyed with me for ages. Old foggy means old fashioned personality. Now starts Vita the turn in her life. When she was in school, she was considered chatterbox by Mr. Keezing. Now, this man, why he keeps on calling her chatterbox? Because she would talk a lot in the class. And because I talked so much. So Anne Frank is confessing it. She knows that she was very talkative. After several warnings, he assigned me extra homework. An essay on the subject, a chatterbox. What can you write about that? I would worry about that later, I decided. I jotted down the title in my notebook, tucked it in my bag and tried to keep quiet. There are 2 ways when a teacher, you know, asks you to keep your mouth shut. teacher can directly scold you or teacher can make you realize that you have done something wrong. So in this case, Mr. Keesing is being very nice. He is not directly giving punishment to Anne Frank. When Anne Frank would talk, he said, Anne Frank, okay, you write one essay. And the title of the essay is Chatterbox, a person who speaks a lot, to whom we call Chatterbox. What she does, she writes the title in the notebook, closes the notebook and just sits and just keeps quiet. That evening, after I had finished the rest of my homework, the note about the essay caught my eye. I began thinking about the subject while chewing the tip of my fountain pen. Anyone could ramble on and leave big spaces between the words, but the trick was to come up with convincing arguments to prove the necessity of talking. Now, rather than leaving this, you can say, act given by the teacher, this homework given by the teacher, she thought and thought, ki, what should I write about being chatterbox? I thought and thought and suddenly I had an idea. I wrote the 3 pages Mr. Keesing had assigned me and was satisfied. I argued that talking is a student's trait and that I would do my best to keep it under control, but that I would never be able to cure myself of the habit since my mother talked as much as I did. If not more, and there is not much you can do about inherited traits. She started writing arguments in the essay or the topic given by Mr. Keesing, that chatterbox. She wrote that my trait is inherited because my mother talks a lot, that's why I talk a lot, and there is nothing bad in that. Mr. Keesing had a good laugh at my argument. So when she showed that essay, a long 3 pages of essay, and what happened? He started laughing. And but when I proceeded to talk my way through the next lesson, he assigned me a second essay. Now what happened? Rather than keeping quiet, Anne Frank, she kept on talking and talking in the next class also. Fine. One chapter was, you can say, done. She was given the homework. But then what happened? She got another, you can say, statement by the teacher, another topic. What was the another topic? Anne Frank as punishment. This was, you can say, an incorrigible chatterbox. Now, what do you mean by incorrigible? Something that cannot be corrected. Fine. So teacher understood by now that this girl is not going to mend her ways. Fine. Then after that, Anne Frank is punishment for talking in class. Write an essay entitled Quack, 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 said Mistress Chatterbox. But even then, she did not stop talking. Then teacher finally changed the topic to that Quack, 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 said Mistress Chatterbox. So he is trying to actually teach this little girl that you should not talk. Okay. So rest of the chapter will continue tomorrow. The bell has gone. Have a nice day with her.